Okay, let's start our third module. We will study classification and prediction in detail. We have to see the basic concepts regarding classification and prediction, and we will study about the issues regarding these two. And we have to study basic techniques involved in classification as well as in prediction. And we will see some accuracy measures and how can we measure the accuracy of classifier models as well as predictor models. Finally, we will discuss about how we can choose a best model to classify our data set. So these are the contents involved in this particular module. I will divide the material into two, three different days. Then we will have different sessions based on each material. So we are moving on to the third module. This particular session will discuss about the introduction regarding classification and prediction, and also the issues regarding these two. Databases are rich with hidden information that can be used for intelligent decision making. These are some general points. Classification and prediction are two forms of data analysis that can be used to extract models describing important data classes or to predict future data trends. This kind of analysis can help provide us with a better understanding of the data at large. You have to look at the basics we have discussed in Day 5, and you can include all those points under this particular topic. We will see what is the difference between classification and prediction once again. Classification predicts categorical, that is known as discrete or unordered labels, whereas prediction models continuous valued functions. So actually, prediction is for numeric prediction, but classification predicts categorical or unordered labels. For example, we can build a classification model to categorize bank loan applications as either safe or risky. We can classify it into two groups, one group is safe, we can provide loan to that particular group, and the other group can be identified as risky. This is a kind of classification or a prediction model to predict the amount that would be safe for the bank to loan an applicant. That is, the loan amount can be predicted for each and every applicant. This is a numeric kind or a continuous valued functions can be used here. So this is an example for prediction model. Basic techniques for data classification are, we have discussed and the outline, but I am repeating the basic techniques that are going to be studied: classification by decision tree induction, Bayesian classification, rule-based classification, classification by backpropagation, support vector machines, associative classification, Bayesian learners, which include k-nearest neighbor classifiers, case-based reasoning, that is CBR. Other classification methods, we will also mention about genetic algorithms, rough set approach, fuzzy set approaches. And we can use different prediction methods, including linear regression, nonlinear regression, and other regression-based models. We will see for numeric prediction, example for numeric prediction. Suppose that the marketing manager would like to predict how much a given customer will spend during a sale at All Electronics. The model constructed predicts a continuous valued function or ordered value as opposed to the categorical label. This model is a predictor. This is another example for numeric prediction. Regression analysis is a statistical methodology that is most often used for numeric prediction. Hence, the two terms are often used synonymously. Regression analysis, or we can say numeric predictor or prediction synonymously. Classification and prediction have numerous applications, including fraud detection, target marketing, performance prediction, manufacturing and medical diagnosis, etc. Data classification is a two-step process, which include learning step and also the classification step. We'll see it by an example by the next slide. A tuple X is represented by an n-dimensional attribute vector X equal to x1, x2 up to xn, depicting n measurements made on the tuple from n database attributes, respectively a1, a2 up to an. So we are considering a tuple as X, and which is represented as a vector, that is, we can represent the tuple X with values x1, x2 up to xn. Each tuple X is assumed to belong to a predefined class as determined by another database attribute called the class label attribute. Okay. So this is the basic representation of a tuple. We will see it by an example.